Hello guys, and welcome to The Music Empire, the channel where we spread the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ through the talents He has given us. And in today's lesson, we want to take a look at Firm Foundation by Maverick City. And as you saw from the cover and then even the descriptions I was given in the cover, you realize that this is a very simple song. In fact, I believe most of you here don't even need me to teach you how to play this song. So what we are coming to do in this lesson is to learn some few chords and some techniques that will make us still be able to keep this song as simple as we can, but at the same time the song will be spiced up. Okay, like we'll do some beautiful stuff to the song, but then we will make it complex. Okay, and so the key that we will be in for this song, it's C sharp, okay? Yeah. So quickly, let's take a look at the major scale for C sharp. C sharp is your 1, E flat is your 2, then F is your 3, F sharp is your 4, A flat or G sharp is your 5, and then B flat or A sharp is your 6, 7 to the 1. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's the scale for C sharp. Well, whatever happens, I'll be mentioning the notes so that even if you are not conversant with the key of C sharp, when you hear the note, you will just transfer it to the key that you want to transfer to. Okay, yes. So there was something I was doing at the intro. Yeah. So this is what I mean by we'll be spicing it up. Okay. Yeah. In the intro, it's mostly one, like the progression for the intro, and then whenever they sing and then they break, it's like the progression will mostly be under one. So though simple, you can just do, and that the song itself is full of guitars, but we don't want to do this throughout, you see. We don't want to be doing stuff like that throughout. So what are some of the things that we can do? Okay, what are some of the things that we can do whilst being under one? So first of all, we want to use these. I was basically using two chords, and then this. I was just inverting them. So the first chord that I want to take a look at is a D flat or a C sharp 13 sus 2 sus 4 chord. So on my left, I just have the C sharp octave itself, and on my right hand, I have the 4 6 flat 7 2. Okay. Normally in the key of C sharp, I will play this over the 5, and I believe most of you play this chord over the 5, right? But this time, now if you play it over the 5, it becomes an A flat minor 9th chord. It's a minor 9th chord. Then we play this over the 6, then this will become a B flat minor 9th chord. But this time, we are playing this chord over the 1, and then it turns it into a C sharp 13 sus 2 sus 4 chord. Okay, so this is the first chord that we have. The second chord will still be on the 1. Yes, and this is the second chord. So I have the 5 7 1 3 on my right hand, still over the 1. Okay, now the third chord is just an inversion of this chord. Just bring this 4 over here. That's all. I maintain the rest of the notes. So this is what you have. Okay, so it's the same chord. It's the same C sharp 13 sus 2 sus 4 chord. Just that I'm taking the F here and I've brought it here. And then in the same way, do the same thing to this chord. Now look at this chord. I'm just taking the 5. I'm maintaining the rest of the notes. And I'm just taking this 5 from this position to this position. Okay? So you see, I'm using just two chords. You see? The same chords. Then I will just use a new chord here. So from here, it's still over the 1. So from here, the next chord I'll play is this. This is like a B major 7, right, over the C sharp chord. Now, the truth of the matter is, I'm not playing a new chord. I'm still playing this same chord. But it's like I just keep expanding and expanding it. Look at this. From here, I inverted this chord here, right, like this. And now from here, I want to invert the same chord. So I have to take this B flat and then place it over here, right? So look, have you noticed? So I'm just playing two chords throughout. And then with this one, let's just invert this last one. Then how will we invert it? We'll take the C and then place it at the next position, or the next C to our right, which is this C over here. And then we get our C sharp major 7th chord, right? Yeah, so this tells you about, or this shows you about the power of inversions. Okay, just two chords, this and this, and I've just inverted them, right? Yeah, so over the 1. Now, at this rate, you can even forget about the song, and then this is a very nice move, right? Like, let's say doing prayers or before worship. You and your gang, I said your gang, you and your band can play this. You see? And it's very nice. And then the drummer too will be hyping it, right? The bass is on the 1. Now the last chord that I will use to end this whole thing I'm doing is, okay, so I just had a 1 4 6 1 before the song itself will start. Now maybe I haven't really listened to that song, but I just listened to it once and then I tried to record the melody and I played it. So pardon me if you feel like at a certain point I don't flow with the progression of the exact progression of the song. I believe whatever I played here goes with the melody. Okay, so we can still learn it that way. So that's the beginning of the song, right? That's if I want to play it melodically. Right. Then the next chord is on the 6. Then 5. That comes back to 1. But on the 1, yeah, I feel like doing this. Like this movement. So let's see. It's just the 1 itself. The first chord is 3, 5, 1. And then I do 4, flat 6, 2. Okay. So 3, 5, 1. 4, flat 6, 2. Then 5, 1, 3. And then I have flat 6, 1, 4. You see, I'm also doing inversions again. With just 2 chords. Then I play it backwards. I don't even know that. I haven't even said the lyrics like that, but I remember the foundation. That's what I remember. So it's like, so you play the chords forward and then backwards, right? The foundation. And we go to the 6. We won't do any passing chord. Just go to the 6. But this is the 6 I'm playing. Okay. So I have 6, 3, 5 on my left. And on my right hand, I have the 7, 1, 3, 5, okay? Then to the 5. 5 is just a regular 5, which is the 5 and then the 2 on my left. And on my right hand, I have the 5, 7, 2, okay? So, six, five. Then we do it again. Yeah, I think it will repeat it all over again. So to the 6 again, 5, then. Sorry. To the 3, right? So let's see for the 6. 5. Now this is the chord I want to do. Yeah, now remember we have done this chord already. Now from the intro we did what? That we did. Remember we did this chord, so that's the same chord we are playing again on the is that part supposed to be the chorus? I don't know. Yeah, but so we know this chord already, right? So that's a chord. Dun, dun, dun. Then we use the same chord to read a melody. So like 1, 2, 3, then come to the 4. Now this is the chord I'm playing on the 4. I have the 4 octave on my left. And on my right, I have the 6, 1, 3, 6. Okay? So, like. So, watch this carefully. So, 4, so like. Then I come to the 3. Now, on the 3, I have 3, 2 on my left. And on my right hand, I have the 5, 1. These are very simple chords, right? So. Now, if you want, you can just do the melody. Sorry, that's a 3, right? So, all you can do. Assuming somebody is singing, right? Then go to the 6. Now, we know the 6 already, so. So, like firm foundation, back to the 3. Then go to the 6, 5, then again to the 4. 3. Now, then we go to the 6 again, but this 6, I don't want us to use this 6. I want us to use. So from this 3, we go to 6, but I want us to play this 6, which is the 3, 6, 1 on my right, with the 6 on my left. And then we go to our regular 5. Okay, so again, it's like 3, 6. Then we start to go all over what we did from the beginning. Now I want you to follow the song and then use this as how you want to, or with your choir. Then it will start all over again. So now we know this chord 6. the one, right? Six. Then. To the three. Six. Then again. Three. Then. Six. It's a human feel. I don't even know the name to give this thing. Now this one gets here, I think, looking at the timing to the healing phase, that part too. When we get to this chord, the third chord, now go to. Yeah, that's what I did, okay. Then we'll go to. I mean, these are the few chords I threw in the song, and I want to show you. So, and the he won't feel like the he won't feel on the 6, 5, 1, 3, 4. Okay, so we know the 6 already, the 3, 6, 1 over the 6, right? So 6, 5. Now I have 2, 5, 7 on my right, with a 5 octave on my left. So 6, 5. Now we come back to this one. You know this one already, right? So 6, 5, 1, then 3. Now those are three I'm playing. I'm playing a 3 and 5 on my left. Otherwise, you can do a 3 on your left like this, 3 octave, and then you play 5, 1, 2, 5 on your right. Okay, so you can do it like this. What will be like 1 to the 3, then to the 4, we know this 4 already, right? Good. So let's see. Next one is. So these chords are just very nice, right? So the next one is 6, 7, 1. Okay, so you have 6 on the 7. I have the 5, 7, 2 on my right hand, which is a 7 on my left. So 6, you know the 6 already, to the 7, then to your 1, you know this one already, 5, 1, 3, right? So we have 6, 7, 1. Now I threw in this passing chord myself. It's very nice. 2, 2. So like 6, 7, 1, 6, 2. Okay. So 6, 7, 1. Let's take a look at this passing chord. I have the 6 and a flat 2 on my left. And on my right hand, I have 5, flat 2, 4. Okay. And this is a very beautiful chord. So we have. The two, I have 2, 6, 4 on my left, and on my right I have 6, 1, 3. Or you can just do 2, 6, 2 on my left as an octave, and on my right I have the F sharp major 7, which is a 4, 6, 1, 3. Okay, so the finger position that you want to use, I like doing this though, I don't know. But I can do this. I feel like this is more simple, right? This finger position is more simple, but I like doing this. I like stretching my left naturally. Then you have come to your 5. You can play this 5, which is 4, 7, 2 as your 5. To the 1. Basically, we are done with the song. Right? We are done with the song. So if you check the cover again, you'll see that this is exactly what I did. So you see. Guys, I've been able to learn this song in a very simple way, and then we just threw in some few chords, and it didn't exaggerate the song, but it made it even more beautiful. Yeah, there are times where such simplicity is the best, not those kind of chords, but this one is the best. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Subscribe if you haven't, turn on your notification icon bell. Okay, and do visit Music Empire for some exclusive wonderful courses over there. We have some wonderful courses teaching about contemporary chords, Ghanaian worship, music theory, praises, everything. So just visit musicempire.com and then get yourself a course that will really help you a lot. God richly bless you. Let's meet in our next lesson.